Blub blub everyone, welcome to Return of the Obra Dinn. We're gonna play this nice little game today and enjoy its interesting art design, which is actually pretty cool. Although it might keep some people away from playing it, which is a shame. I hope not. Because this is an awesome game about deduction and about figuring out what happened to a ship on a lonely ship on an ocean which was deserted by its crew. Hey Daniel, welcome. And yeah, let's just enjoy it. No fate solved. No, we will solve every fate in this game. I'm gonna play this until we all figure it all out. Lost at sea, 1803. The good ship Obra Dinn, built 1796 in London, 800 tons, 18 feet draught. Captain R. Witterell, crew 51 men. Last voyage to Orient, Cape Rendezvous unmet. Oh, thanks, Silent Assassin, for raiding. Welcome and hello. And I wanted to read that, come on. Honorable East India Company, attention, Chief Inspector, Insurance and Claims London Office, that's us. The Obra Dinn has returned, dispatched to Falmouth immediately and prepare a full assessment. That's what we're gonna do. Very nice. Welcome, welcome, Silent Assassin and Raiders. I hope you're having fun too. And I hope you had fun at the stream. Wait, let me give you a shout out. Can I? Please, without the game just going further. Silent underscore assassin double S's 10. Does that work? It does. Great. Everyone should look into him for some nice portal action, apparently. Nice. Falmouth, England, 1802, and that sounded great.
Said you'd need ferry to the Obra Dinn. Not many eager for that job.
I don't know yet. We just started, Silent Assassin, so you're in perfect time.
I didn't.
What's in the box?
I don't know. I'll hoist it up in a few minutes.
Hey! How?
Carefully.
Okay, we just arrived. I don't like the borders. I think we should go back to having, where is it? Can't I change that now? No, output sharp there, smooth, and I'm gonna have to wait a second. Is it? Wait, I fixed it already, right? Yeah, I did. Just one second. Let me just there. That should be better. Perfect. Okay. Now we can start. Yes, that's way better. Just get my mouse a little bit slower in DPI. Perfect. We are at the Obra Dinn, deep at sea. No land in sight. And he brought us here and we have to deduce the fate. Can I? Well, apparently the guy really wants to get up there. So... okay, mouse click. Perfect. That looks so good. Just so simple and minimalistic, but it just gets the point across and I like it. I like the style. I'm not sure about the sepia tones. We could change that into something else, but in the end, I think that isn't better in any way whatsoever. Neither is this. Although it's a little bit warmer, which could be nice, but... yeah, no. Maybe. Maybe this could be a little bit clearer, but actually I like the... yeah, that's very sharp. I don't know, maybe that is fine too. Just the LCD monitor. But let's just stay with a Macintosh. It's just a little bit... I don't know, it's not as hard of a contrast. And I find that nice. You like the aesthetic, Silent Assassin? Yeah, me too. It looks kinda nice. Although it is very minimalistic. Now let's see. Let's just look around. I am not a boat, actually ship specialist, so I totally know every term there is, especially in English, for the aft of the ship and the I'm already lost. For everything ship related. So bear with me, please. I think we will get that. Oh, look, there's something blinging over there. Some bling bling. Unfortunately, we have no boat and we cannot use this ship. Well, because of that mostly, but also because this ship probably needs a crew of at least 20 men, I would guess. Just look around a bit further first. Oh, would you look at that? A dead person. Huh. Okay, it's E or right mouse click. Interesting. You are pretty dead, my friend. So, we found our first corpse. Well, it's not actually a corpse. It's a skeleton already. Corpse means there's still some flesh on the bones, and there isn't. Interesting. Okay, I think we need to go back to the boat. Yeah.
It's too heavy.
It certainly needs more than the skeleton crew we currently have to sail anywhere. Ha! I see what you did there. Well, the awkward. I see what you did there. What's wrong, my friend? Well, I didn't get my chest, so could you please hoist it up here?
It's too heavy. Take it yourself or open it here.
Great. Okay, there's a book in there. Would you take that? Apparently you do. Great. Now, A and D to go through the pages. Return of the Obra Dinn, a catalogue of adventure and tragedy, 1807. Interesting, so the current year. Preface. I trust that you now find yourself aboard the Obra Dinn. I expected this day to come, and my every intention was to tell the ship's strange tale within the pages of this book. Regrettably, failing health has allowed me to produce only the basic outline that follows. Your presence on the Obra Dinn is critical. I leave the discovery of its fate and the completion of this book in your hands. The next few pages would seem bewildering at first. All will make sense in time. Use the pocket watch to determine the identity and fate of everyone aboard. Yeah, that's the magic pocket watch, apparently. Complete each chapter accurately and return the book to guaranteed post to the by guaranteed post to the French Office of Affairs in Morocco. Morocco, that is an interesting place already. The bargain chapter will remain unknown to you. I possess the details within, but have elected to keep them private for now. Henry Evans. We have to remember this name. Contents. The journey, the ship, the crew, life at sea, a sketch, the glossary, and the back cover. And the chapters are Loose Cargo, A Bitter Cold, Murder, The Calling, Unholy Captives, Soldiers of the Sea, The Doom, Bargain, Escape, and The End. And we know Bargain at 94 is not in yet. And we cannot know this at this point, or at any point, until the end of the game. Atlantic Leg of the Far East Route, okay. The ship with the orlop deck here. Deck plans for the Obra Dinn. So we have the journey. Can I... Oh, yeah. With W and S, I can go up and down. So the journey came... No, you were supposed to get here at the Cape. And you never arrived there. Or was it Cape Verde? No, I think this was your rendezvous point. And you never got there. So, yeah, and we are... I don't know where we are yet. I think about here or something. Or we aren't far from the African coast, I think. If I remember right. Madeira, the Azores, Canary Islands, Africa, and Cape Verde. From Europe. So you were... You weren't even starting from London. You were starting from Cornwall somewhere. Which is interesting. Okay. That's the ship, the surgery, the crew quarters, starboard walk, this thing, the carpenter's shop, which is here the orlop deck, purser's office. Okay, there's a lot of stuff as we can see. And we probably have to go everywhere to figure out what happened. We have the complete crew manifest, which is interesting. This is where we get the names from. So there were 60 people aboard at one point. And that these are sketches from the life on board. Yeah, and here we can figure out who's who. Interesting. And can assign their names probably in something. Okay. Loose cargo. And there is... Well, we are on the cargo deck. Are we? Okay, I wouldn't have called it a cargo deck, but it's fine. No, we're not. Okay, this is where it starts. Okay, on the orlop deck, on the cargo deck. The murder outside the first mate's window. Okay. The murder. Let's go there. Skim through the entire... Really? I have to skim through the entire book before I can close it. I don't know why. But that's fine. This is the bargain. This chapter will remain unknown until you leave the ship and return the book to me. Henry Evans. Okay. The escape. And we have to do it correctly, of course. Inside the captain's quarters, the end. And there's the glossary. Oh yeah, where we can look up what the different designations mean. Like the captain, like the mate, the bosun, the gunner. Most people don't know what the bosun is, including me. So, yeah, that would be nice. This is an indicator of how many dead people we got. We got figured out, I think. That's fine. Okay, and there is the ominous watch with a skull on it. Memento mortem. Remember death, exactly. Just wanted to say that. Okay. Thanks, mister. Don't know why this box must be so heavy if there's only a book and a watch in it, but it's fine, you lazy bum. Unfortunately. You can never count on anyone, right? Okay, so we saw a corpse there. And now it is... I don't know. Are those flies? I would say they're flies. Let's say they're flies. And we are just using the watch on this... Skeleton. Skeletal remains. Nice that the clothes are still on. Very cool.
Captain! Open the door! Kick it in. Lest we break it down and take more than those shells.
You shells? Okay.
Exactly what I give you.
So it's a mutiny, apparently. Okay, you got shot in the throat. Or actually the chest. With an axe in hand. Well, that happens if you mutiny against your captain. If you mutiny against your captain, that's supposedly the captain, I would say. With a magnificent beard. He has to be the captain. Is that all? I want to go there. No? So three people we can see. Anyone else? No. Is the music okay at this? The side. Oh, there's another guy. Hello, mister. I have a knife in my mouth. That isn't safe at all. So you were going probably to surround the captain or something? And now we're out. As far as I know, we can get into any memory of anyone's death at any time. Just the first time is special. Okay, we start with the end, as you do. Every good book. You always just break it open at the end and read the ending first. Why wouldn't you spoil yourself? Who is this? How did they die? There's the location of the corpse. Three others were present. And he's saying captain, so it's these three. This guy, okay, and this guy. And we already know who this is, apparently, because if they aren't, if they are sharp, we know everything about them. Or we should know everything about them to identify them. Gotta go for some food? Well, have a nice one. And I hope you're coming back afterwards and enjoy some. Audio seems to be at a good level. That's perfect. Okay, nice. Thank you. Good. Well, let's see. Unknown. One memory. Memories where this person appears can be navigated from here. The soul appears in one memory. First memory, 126. Show memories on deck. Bookmark memories. Bookmark all memories where they appear for quicker navigation. Okay. He's bookmarked. I love these sound cues. Whenever something happens, these nice little sound cues, they sound so great. This person's face is no longer blurred. Exactly. The blurred faces we cannot know yet, but the not blurred, the sharp faces we can know. Use the book and the pocket watch to gather enough information to deduce their identity. Revisit memories on the ship using the pocket watch to study relationship appearances and activities. Use the book, maps, crew manifest, and artist sketches, along with the individual conversation logs to find clues about. There were 60 people on the ship when it left England. Determining everyone's identity and fate will not be easy. Decisive information is rare. You will have to make assumption using partial information. Some identities may only be revealed through a process of elimination. Good luck. Well, thank you. It wishes us good luck. I love it. Okay, let's just say, well, who would you be? You have the magnificent beard, and I think this, because of the hat that we can see here, if we could I go back here? You just look like a normal crewman in some way. You have a magnificent hat, and at those times, probably only officers had those. And yours is more magnificent than his, as far as I can see. So I would say you're the captain. Robert Witterell, captain from England. Captain Robert Witterell. Okay, we don't get any confirmations yet. As far as I know, you get confirmations every 5 people you successfully deduce. So that's nice. Let's just look around some more. Okay, so we don't know who you are. We don't know who you are yet. But we know you are the captain and you just murdered someone of your crew. In a nice dress. You're probably an officer of some kind. Although I would like to see your hat. And you left your hat. You cannot be a good crewman. Having a hat and not wearing it, that's just... Oh, well, the captain doesn't either, but he's just murdering his crew, so probably that's why. And your axe is still lying there. So the other guy didn't pick up the axe, apparently. Which is interesting. Okay, I can go in here. Little cabin. Interesting cabin with something like a bed or... To me, it actually looks like a coffin, but it's fine. Okay, now would you please close? Close. Close, close. Thank you. Need to go through here. Is there another entrance? Those are closed. Okay. Nothing to find here. There's the shiny thing again. Okay, I'm interested in what's going on there. Okay. This door has an X down there. So I can't go through. This one doesn't. Okay. That makes sense. No, let's see. There's another cabin and another dead. And 2 dead, actually. Well, let's start with you. Oh! You have a head like the guy standing with this officer guy. So you're probably the other crewman there, mutinying.
Where are they? Must be in here someplace. They're at the bottom of the sea. That's a lie.
Okay. Some fight. Close combat fight. Not a gun again. But yeah, if you know those guns, they cannot be... Oh. Reloaded that fast. Well, I think this guy... Oh, look at this one. Sneaky bastard that you are. Apparently... yeah, that's the captain. He slashed him through the throat. Oh, but got the spear in the shoulder. Oh, damn. And there's the gun. So he won't make it, probably, with that wound. Maybe. It's just the shoulder. Bad for the arm, though. And the other guy is lying outside. Okay, interesting. At first, you only have a few moments to grasp the scene, which is interesting. And after that, you can watch the scene as much as you like, I think. Who is this and how did they die? Where are they? They must be in here someplace. They're at the bottom of the sea. That's a lie. Okay. So the X must be the guy that lies dead on the floor. So that's this strange guy. And he said at the bottom of the sea? Oh, right. Weren't they talking about some shells or something? So the captain says he threw some shells to the bottom of the sea and they are pissed about that? Okay. Yeah, we're on the main deck in the captain's quarters. Oh, that's the passengers' cabins. Okay, with the captain. Interesting. Interesting, interesting. Okay, so it was you and we know you're the captain, but do not know who you are. And we cannot deduce that yet. I mean, that's fine. Fine with me, but you? You are here too. Why does the game not recognize this? Maybe because you're not quite in the scene, just at the edge of the scene. Probably we will find a scene with you in a second. How do I get out of here? Through this door. There's more to this sketch if you scroll up. Wait. Open the book while the pocket watch is open to flip directly to the relevant page. Yeah, that's fine. I don't care. To this sketch. Yeah, I know. Oh, there's the guy. Oh, thank you, Wealthy Artwork. Okay, cool. Yeah, so the game recognizes that he's there. Okay, I'm just dumb. It's fine. Yeah, what I can remember from what I have seen is that this is, of course, not a photograph. It's a sketch, so... It doesn't mean that this scene has happened with all these people like that. Or that this scene has happened like that. But the artist, of course, wanted to have everyone here. So, at these sketches, there's another sketch, isn't there? Was it these two? Wait, let's just look at the contents with Q. And... No, it's this whole sketch. Okay. This is called Underway. For motion royalty, interesting. And the justice at sea. So they killed someone, apparently. They shot him. Or her. That's probably a him. Because the crew were all men. But the royalty, there's a woman. And I saw some women here, yeah. Okay. And you could be a woman too. So I think these three are women. Yeah, I think so. The others look like guys. You look very strange, man. Probably Indian or something, right? Isn't that a turban? I don't know, it's very blurry. No, thanks. It's fine. Okay, we have another fate to deduce. Cannot go through that door. So let's look at this fate. Yeah, the guy who jumped down here must be this guy, or it must be the captain. Nah, I think it's the guy that jumped down here because he's lying right next to this place. Which would have happened a few seconds later. Still the shiny thing there. Let's just look at that. Yeah, drowning in his own blood. Great. Thanks. Wow, he just killed this guy. My god, the captain is a killing machine. He killed this guy. Draw the spear out of his freaking shoulder and knock this guy dead. This guy is amazing. What can I do here? There was a button prompt or something. Okay, to zoom probably. So he got shift in the kidneys or something. Then he pulled the spear from his shoulder and knocked him dead in the head. All the while he was suffocating on his own blood. God damn it. Oh, would you look at that. Someone is lying here. A woman. I think I saw her on the sketches. She's the long-haired woman, as it appears. Interesting. Oh, I love this. I love how you get just a little bit more information with every scene. It's pretty cool. It was prompting you to hold E or right mouse button while looking at somebody's face. So yeah, I saw that correctly. Okay. Thank you about the Aardvark. Righteous Boner! Hello! Welcome! This ship is cursed beyond doubt. Yeah, it seems to be. It really seems to be. Who is this and how did they die? Yeah. I mean, there can't be a transcript of you suffocating on your own blood. That is just gruesome. How would you transcribe that? So, he was present again, of course, because this was the ambusher, asshole. And the captain was there, but there was another one there. Not only this guy, but what's with the woman? I think it was her, right? She's the only long-haired woman, as it appears, if those two are women. And this one. And she didn't look like foreign royalty. I think it was this girl. Or woman, or whatever. I hope you're having a good time, Gratis Boner. How are you today? Okay, nothing else going on. Yeah, I want to know who you are. Maybe the door is open now and we can discover her death. There's no sea outside. You can't see anything. Well, there is probably, but it's not part of the memory. I want such a fancy watch, guys. Where can I get one? Give me three. It's fine. That's a really fancy watch, man. Okay, so your death is clear to us now. Oh, look at that. There's someone lying in there. Oh. We didn't find the captain. You seem to be the woman because you're lying in exactly the same pose as she did. So could that be the captain? I would guess so. Let's look at that.
Abigail. Your brother. My friend.
Mm-hmm.
I shot him.
Oh? Dead. Oh, that's a good clue.
I'll be with you soon.
Oh, you have got a deadline tomorrow, Righteous Boner.
Please,
I'm sorry to hear that.
Forgive me.
I hope you're in time still. Oh. And there he shot himself, the poor guy. And the boys are meeting today, so you know, okay. Still nice of you to take a look today. And come by. So yeah, that's the captain. That's totally the captain. Who just shot his... Okay, not the head. You shot yourself in the chest. I would probably prefer the head if you do it at all. And she's here too. So he said he shot her brother. So we know she must be Abigail, I think. I think he meant her because he was in the same room with her. And she was one of the guests because she's lying in that thing. And that must be her brother then. So we have to look for an Abigail in the ship's manifest and for her last name, and we will find her brother and can identify this guy too. Yeah, that was no unknown fate, my friend. Come on. He shot a gun, was shot by a gun by himself. Is he Okay. He wasn't shot by a gun then. He took his own life. Is there suicide in here? Suicide. Shot himself. There it is. This may or may not be correct, yeah? Fates are validated in sets of three. Correctly identifying at least three people and their fates to have the information typeset into the book. Three people. Okay, that is, seems to be easy because we have three people we can identify now. The fate, that's something else. But three people who can be identified. I think that's correct, though, because we saw him shoot himself in the chest. Let's see. Yeah, and I want to identify you, guy. Can I do that? You. Who's Abigail? Abigail. She must be a passenger, right? So there are a few. Abigail Hoscott Witterell. So Hoscott. Witterell was her, probably the captain. She was probably married to the captain then. And I think it's Hoscott. Who is Hoscott? William Hoscott, the first mate from Scotland. That must be her brother. And he was shot with a gun by the freaking captain. There we are. I think that must be correct. And yeah, look at the beard here and there. The Scotsman, he got shot by the captain. What a gruesome fate. Is there the Abigail woman? No, there isn't. Oh, that's sad. Let's just get out of here and look for Abigail in the rooms. Because we saw her skeletal remains there. Okay. 2, 3, 4. 4 dead. So Abigail isn't counted in the end. So she didn't die here, I guess. I bet she died in another chapter. And this is just her dead body that was lying in here because the captain didn't want to bury her at sea. Which would be the custom, right? To just throw her off the plank? In a ceremony, not just throwing her. Let's just look at how you died. Okay. Oh god, what the fuck? Yeah, something happened to this ship. Yeah, that's... So she must be Abigail, and she was struck... Oh, in the face. Yeah, that would kill you. And she must have been talking to this guy. This guy was called Martin by her. And she wanted to talk to the captain, apparently. There are two people here. Yeah, you are as stumbled as I am about the freaking giant kraken out there. You are trying to shoot that guy. Interesting who you might be. There's another two guys. Oh, come on, game. Let me just look at it some more. Oh, you didn't know? Tentacle love, baby. Yeah, apparently. We are now in hentai. The Doom. Okay. Between the Azores and the Canary Islands. Okay. Inside the captain's quarters. 10 others were present. Who is this and how did they die? Well, I would say this is Abigail Hoscott Witterell, so the wife of the captain, and she was, yeah, what was she clubbed? No. She killed with a sword? No. She's not alive. She wasn't axed, burned, or clawed. She wasn't decapitated, luckily. She wasn't strangled. She was struck. No, not by hoofs or tails or wings. Hoofs? Suicide. She wasn't torn apart. She wasn't speared or spiked. She wasn't poisoned. Killed by a sword, froze, fell, exploded, expired. Oh my god, what the fuck did happen to you guys? She wasn't eaten, she wasn't drowned. No, she wasn't. Was she clubbed? By a beast? Bro, what happened? Yay! Three fates are correct! Woohoo! Nice. William is correct. Great, 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 great. And the captain is correct. Woohoo! She went to the club, yeah. Forever. Okay, this is the death clock, apparently. We got three. Very nice. That game is so cool. I want more like these. This is a puzzle game I can get behind. Oh, I can, apparently? Does that mean I can get into this fate, too? Or something. It's still going. Action with space. Okay. Yes, it shows me another. Okay, probably because there wasn't a dead body here, right? But he died here. Interesting. Interesting how they went about doing this. But that means the stuff is interconnected in a way. And now it shows me where I have to go? Okay, I have to release it and then I can follow. That sounds so wrong. Yes? Or maybe there is a body lying here? Oh, now there is. Okay, it shows me the dead guy. Well, he looks a little bit short, and he doesn't, with the arms, he doesn't look like a dwarf, so I would say he was torn apart, wouldn't you? Oh, damn. Poor bastard, man. Poor bastard. Half the man he used to be. I like you, Wealthy Aardvark. Oh, that, the sounds, man. Oh, that is so gruesome. Guys! Okay. Yeah, he looks like... He looks very torn apart. While he's trying to poke the bear. Oh, there is already the sword of this guy in this thing. And it doesn't fucking care. Can I see you? I can't. Sad. There's another guy around here. Apparently drinking or something. I don't know. Looks very foreign. Could be from the foreign royalty, someone or something. You are throwing some guns to this guy, okay. And you are clinging for your life, and there's someone dead, and there's someone shooting and cowering, and oh my god, so many people everywhere. I love the music. So good. Okay, who is this and how did they die? I have no freaking idea who this tattooed man is. But we know how he died. He was definitely torn apart by a beast. Yes, I would say so. But we do not know who this guy is. Although we apparently can because he's not blurred. That is interesting. How would we know? Yeah, we should be able to deduce who he is. We can't deduce these guys yet. Don't have enough information. We could deduce this guy. I think this is Martin, right? We can't deduce this one. Must be Martin. We don't know how he died, though. But we know that this must be... Yeah, he must be a mate, right? Because of the hat. Martin Perrault? or parrot. I don't know. Maybe he's a parrot. He's the obligatory parrot in every pirate movie. She called him, Abigail called the guy Martin, and he had this beard. So I guess it's this one. Is there another Martin? No. There's no other Martin, so it must be this guy. I don't think there is any doubt. Let's just go with that. We don't know. It's the third mate. We don't know how he died, though. Mm-hmm, in this sketch, first memory is there. Just saw that, but we don't know how he died. We can apparently figure out who that guy is. I mean, he has tattoos. But who the hell has tattoos? India, Persia, maybe? No, he doesn't look Persian, I think. Which is risky to say that on the internet, I know, but... Could he be the New Guinea guy? I don't know. I think we need to find some more information first before we can deduce. I mean, New Guinea, actually, that could be. Because it is custom there, I think, to tattoo yourself or scar yourself or something. Some of these things. I had a presentation once about these customs. Because it's proof that you can survive in this environment. If you can survive these tattoos. Because that means your genes are good enough to get rid of to fight the illnesses and stuff that could occur to you while this was done. Or actually while this was healing. It's very interesting, actually. So maybe it's New Guinea? But I'm not sure. Let's just wait. Okay, apparently there's more in this scene. Oh, this guy, okay. Yeah, you definitely died here. Let's see how. Man, that's going fast. Okay. Where do you want me to go? Probably here, right? Because he was lying here. Yes, that's fine. I looked through your silly ways. This game is so unique. It's great. That was the guy who was torn apart. Oh. Oh, that was a powder explosion. And he died here, so he probably exploded. As we can see there. Okay, yeah. You were supposed to hold him? Get him out of there? But the powder exploded and killed him. Anyone else here? You too. You were the sword. Oh, you were the guy who was torn apart. Mr. Tattooed guy. And you were getting the guns. Okay. Weren't you the one who gets one thrown? Maybe you threw it at him? No, I don't think so. I think you had the gun thrown towards you from... In the other scene, the scene before, from here. Oh, there's a goat there. Nice. Maybe the Kraken just wanted to have a snack. A goat snack. You could have given him the goat, come on. Interesting scenes, interesting. The Doom. From the end right towards the Doom. Who is he and how did he die? We don't know who he is. We can't figure it out apparently because it's blurred. But we know that he exploded. He was blasted by an explosion. Because there, get to the main bit quick. Yeah, and he got thrown off and into the Kraken with the powder keg probably. No, he should throw the powder. Yeah, he was trying to throw the powder at the Kraken, probably not at the arm, probably at the bit down the sea, to murder that thing or actually annoy it so much that it leaves or something. It's interesting. These people were present. We can't figure out who they are yet. This seems to be another mate or another officer of some kind. Okay. Yeah, and we should be able to know who he is. Just because I want to go with my hunch, and we have to get some, we have to do some assumptions here. I want to say this is the New Guinea guy, just because I have a hunch. I actually don't know anymore. He could be a topman. I want to read something. Bring me to the glossary, please. What is the topman? Higher rated seaman, specializing in work above the deck in the sails and rigging. Okay, could be. The mate, officer or tradesman that supports and assists their superior. General mates help to run the ship and serve at the captain's request. Tradesman mates serve their supervisor. Okay. The bosun. Alternative boatswain or bosun. Okay. Foreman in charge of general crew operations and equipment required to sail the ship. And the gunner, probably because of the guns, right? Military officer in charge of weapons and military procedures. Oh, really? Really military procedures on the ship? That is interesting. The purser, administrative official, accounts for all cargo value and trade transactions, manages a small items store for crew. That is interesting, actually. That is interesting. Well, the helmsman is the guy who helms is at the helm of the ship. Rated seaman in control of the ship's wheel and general moment-to-moment navigation. The steward, servant to an officer or higher rated crew member performing general duties for the comfort of their employer. Okay, and the midshipman, officer in training. Oh, assists various officers and tradesmen in order to learn ship operations, usually of privileged status. Interesting. He could have been a topman. The rigging. The network of ropes and chains supporting the mast. Okay, that one I knew. And the different decks. What's the orlop deck? I never heard that one. Mid deck above the lowest deck containing storage, cabins, animal pens, and the ship's steering tiller. Okay. Interesting stuff. Okay, thanks for that one. Interesting. But we cannot deduce any of those people. Not even this guy. We don't know who he is. We just know how he died. Well then. Interesting. So you got attacked by a Kraken. Pretty nice. I like the sound. Oh, that's so good. I would have liked to have such a watch, pocket watch, someday. But so far I didn't get one. Okay, anyone else we can look at? No, now we are at an impasse. Okay, so we could probably go to a lower deck. Just one deck down, could we? Yeah, because it's open now. Okay. Because we saw people come up here, so that's accessible now. Oh damn, the cannon deck. Okay, it's probably the gun deck. I would guess. I saw someone getting crushed by a gun. Can't go through there. Yeah, normally the guns are strapped, but when this thing is getting loose, you are dead. You probably get crushed. That thing weighs tons. Weeks? Okay, there's a dead guy. And we can't get through to the rest of the ship yet. So we probably have to look at him a bit more. There are cannonballs lying around. Loose cannons. Oh god, that looks so bad. That looks like a cannon shot at the ship. Let's just look at you first. No, he didn't. No, he didn't. Oh, damn, look at that. Oh, crushed in the throat. Yeah, that's a gruesome death. And this guy? Probably not the gunner, right? And who are you? Anyone else? Oh yeah, you two guys? Oh, you were coming down here? Huh. Some utensils being thrown around. At least the rest of the cannons are still fixed. Oh well, this one isn't. Oh, that's bad. Oh, that could kill you so hard and so easy. Who are you? Oh, there's another guy there. Does anyone survive this hell? Yes, there must be survivors. I don't know how many though. I don't think there were many. So, we don't know who you are, but you're probably crushed by a freaking cannon. So, that's nice. Great end. That's my... Oh, was this Martin? You exploded. You're the guy... Oh, that's so nice that it writes this down here. That's perfect. You exploded. Anything else? You. Okay, we don't know. So, Martin. That must have been Martin there. You. I mean, yeah, but you look like two other guys, too. And another dead guy. Oh. Is it just me, or is there something missing from him? Like, the arm and the rest? This is so much fun. Would you please go straight there? Thanks. Yeah, this is... Oh, this looks so bad. This ripped through the outer hull. And probably hit you. Oh, damn. Well, you got hit by a cannonball in the face. So... Okay, so this one guy wasn't crushed yet. Oh, look at him! The torn apart guy. And... Who of you was crushed again? Oh, nice, I can see them. Okay. I can see... Oh, that's you. So you survived till the end. And you got torn apart. Okay, interesting. That's cool that I can do that. So, I don't know who you are. And you are this guy with the top hat. Interesting. Very cool. Well, the top hat guy apparently died by decapitation by a cannon. Was it decapitated? Or is it shot by not by a gun, shot by a cannon? Blasted by a cannon. I don't know if this counts as decapitation or being blasted by a cannon. He was decapitated though. There was nothing left from the head. Actually, one part of the shoulder was missing too. I will just say decapitated just to acknowledge that decapitation is in there. And you... Who were you? The fuse. No, you just have a you. Were you the guy who were crushed by the other cannon? I'm not sure. I couldn't look at you, I think. I think you were the one who was crushed. You were this guy. But I can't see you, so... Yeah, now it's you, okay. Well, that can't go far. Yeah, I was thinking as much. Come on, baby! Oh, we are already an hour in, so I do a little cut. I put a little cut in here, and we will see each other again next time on YouTube, and the stream will of course continue. See you then, bloop bloop.